It was in a vehicle that had been in the river for approximately 2 months. At the point where they brought it to me, the phone had popped open due to the battery expanding, and the entire interior of the phone was completely smashed with mud from the river it was in. I took the phone and got an exemplar phone, the exact same phone, so that I would have a working phone that I knew would be a good exemplar. I then took the heart or the memory out of that phone, out of the messed up phone. It was bent. I had to bend it back, and I spent about a week cleaning it, only because I would clean it, do a really good cleaning process on it, and then I would put it in the exemplar, and it wouldn't start up. So I'd start the next day doing that whole process again. Finally, the very last day, as I was looking through it in a microscope, I noticed underneath one of the heat shields, there was some green in there, which would tell me there was corrosion. And I took a couple bristles of a toothbrush and took some cleaning products and cleaned it that for about an hour. And then went and did my whole cleaning process again, let it sit for a while till I knew it was dry. And then I put it in the exemplar and finally it started up. That actual case, there was a lot of question as to who was telling the truth about the individual that was missing. And this was able, getting this information corroborated everybody's story. And it showed that nobody was lying. Everybody was telling the truth as to what happened to this person.